Good morning, guys. How you doing? And welcome to this installment of Mike's Vehicle Vlogs. And as you can see, I just woke up not too long ago. There's really no point in me cleaning up for the day yet because we're going to go under the car and do a couple of things this morning. The first thing that I'm going to do is the car's due for oil change. It's at 4,300 miles on the oil. I was going to change around 5, but I might as well do it now because I'm actually going to end up changing another fluid while we're under there, and it's actually the first time that I've done this, but I'm going to attempt to do it anyway. We're going to change out the transmission fluid. The reason why I'm going to change the transmission fluid is because I've actually noticed a change in the transmission shifts over this past winter, particularly from the second to third gear. They were extremely harsh shifts when the transmission's still cold. Once it warmed up, it kind of got back to normal, but the second to third was kind of jolty at first. Kind of did some research on that, and a lot of people commented about the fluid in the transmission on the Ford Escape. Ford Escape is equipped with the 6F35 transmission, which is the 6-speed automatic. No select shift feature. It's just a 1 through 6 low range selection here in the car. So it's just a basic 6-speed automatic. And the fluid that's equipped in this transmission is called Mercon LV. And I guess from what I've read and seen a lot of videos on in regards to this Mercon LV is that it breaks down quite easily. And a lot of people said that, you know, you should probably change your transmission fluid roughly around 30,000 miles or so, because that's how quickly it ends up breaking down. My car currently has 79,053 miles on the odometer, and I honestly don't know if this transmission fluid has ever been changed in this car. I figured I might as well give it a shot and change it out anyway, because if for example, if it's 30,000 miles, it's already like overdue, way overdue. It probably should have been done at 30,000, 60,000, the upcoming 90,000, but we're going to do it now. And it actually seems like a very simple process. It really doesn't seem like something, at least on this car, that you can screw up. I know a lot of times when you want to drain your transmission, you have to pull the pan out and such. I don't think there's too many vehicles that actually have a drain plug, but this transmission does. So it's very similar to changing the engine oil. You just undo the plug and let it run out, and then you basically just fill it back up. Of course, there's a couple of other steps along the way. So we're actually going to put the Mercon LV back into it. I've done research about this. This is it right here, Mercon LV. It is an actual Motorcraft product. So we are going to put this back in. I bought 5 quarts because it seems that a lot of the videos that I've seen on this particular transmission, 5 quarts does the trick. It fills it up. So hopefully we'll test that to see if it's true. You know, I looked at some of the other fluids and stuff, and there are a lot of transmission fluids that I found that do not recommend use in a car that requires Mercon LV. Now, I've seen some for, you know, like other Mercon product, but not Mercon LV. One of them even said, do not use in vehicles with Mercon LV. So, I thought it best to stick with the actual Motorcraft product, only because a lot of the things that I read online and seen videos on, you know, this stuff's designed for that transmission. Even though it breaks down and such, it's really not that big of a deal. But it's designed for all of the inner workings of this particular transmission. Rather play it safe. And it actually wasn't that expensive at all. I thought it was going to be much, much worse. I found another brand. I did find one other brand that was safe for Mercon LV transmissions, but it was like $2 more a quart than what this is. So I saved money by actually getting the official Motorcraft product. So, like I said, we're going to put that back into the transmission. And other than that, like I said, we're just going to do an oil change while I'm at it. Since I'm going to be under there, we'll just go from there. So what I'm going to do now, the car sat all night, obviously, because I just got up. And I've read a couple of different things about how you should change the fluid. Should it be cold? Should it be hot? I've seen a lot of things about people saying that it should be warm. I'm not going to do it when it's hot, but I am going to take it out for a drive. Just for a couple minutes or so, get the transmission somewhat warmed up, maybe get the fluid circulating, because another point that somebody mentioned was, if there's any contaminants in the transmission and such, they'll be mixed into the fluid, we'll be able to drain them out a little bit. So, it's also very important to drain the fluid on this, because the filter for this transmission is built into the transmission itself, so you cannot change the filter in this car without tearing the transmission apart. And I think that's something that nobody really wants to do. I know I don't want to do it. I don't know what the actual expectancy of the life for the fluid is, only because I don't have the manuals in the house. I wanted to see what it was, but I mean, I'm assuming it was probably like 100,000 miles or so, but hopefully, it wasn't due any sooner, and, changing this fluid's not going to cause any further damage to the transmission. But at 79,000, I figure it's still pretty safe to have the fluid changed. So I'm going to turn the camera off now, and like I said, we're just going to take the car out for a little bit, get it warmed up, get the fluids all circulated. Then we'll crawl underneath, and I'll show you guys what we need to do to drain the fluid out of the transmission. So, let's go.
Alright, so I'm back. I drove for like 5 miles or so and took some back roads, so I got it up to pretty good speeds, and the engine's, of course, at normal temp, so the transmission, I'm sure, is warm enough now. Here's the transmission fluid dipstick. The dipstick itself even says use mark on LV, so it does look kind of dark, I think. So maybe it's a good thing we're changing it. Alright. So for this, of course, we have all of the things for the oil change. Got my 5W20 synthetic blend, the filter, the oil funnel, the oil, pan, I guess. A new roll of shop towels, because we might need them. I don't know, maybe not. My other one's still pretty good. Your tools. And then for the transmission side of it, the Murakon LV. This old oil thing that I used to use, you can see there's still some oil in it, so when this fluid comes out, it's going to look really dark once it hits this, but it's because of that old oil that sat in there for so long. And then a brand new funnel, because you do not want to use an existing funnel. You don't want to contaminate fluids that are not Murakon LV, so we got a brand new funnel to put the new fluid into the transmission. Something's leaking. Huh. I might have a leak of some sort. Probably coming from the transmission. Because it looks kind of wet. Now, this is news to me, my transmission probably has a leak somewhere from the looks of it. Anyway, so, here's the front bumper, and then right here is a plastic shield. The transmission is pretty much underneath this plastic shield, the first half of it. So, as you can see, there's a bolt here, I believe. It was 10 millimeter. That's what I read. Yeah, 10 millimeter. And there's a couple of other bolts that go around. I believe there's one right here. There's some on the side next to the tire. On this car, you could probably get away with doing this from what I have seen. So if we take this one out, we can tuck this in, and then that drain plug is going to be right on the other side. So I was curious to take the whole thing off because I kind of want to see where this leak is coming from and how long it's been leaking. So I guess we'll just start by taking this thing off here. Snap off. If you have an impact gun, you might want to use the impact gun. There we go. Doesn't look too bad. I should have bought some like anti-seize or something. And there's the plug right there, that little stub. But yeah, so the stub is right there, that little thing right here. That's gonna be our plug to drain everything out. Okay, so I finally got it to fold up, so we don't necessarily have to take that entire thing off. And as you can see, it just clears the plug there, so we should just be able to loosen that up and let it drain. I can't really crawl in too far because of this splash guard up here. But I am trying to see with the camera what exactly is leaking. I'm not getting a very good view. Probably just a seal right there. Can't tell. Alright, so, now I think that one, from what they said, is a 7/16. So, let me change out my socket, and, we'll grab the pan, get it ready, and we'll let it drain out. Ooh, that is black. Okay, so this is probably still the original fluid, so I'm really glad we are doing this. Oh yeah. Definitely time for a change. There's like no red in that at all. In the meantime, I'm going to clean this off, this plug, and yeah, we'll just let this drain out. Okay, so that's finishing up now. We're just getting to some drips. In the meantime, we'll go ahead and loosen up the oil plug, get the oil drained. So now the engine oil is draining. It's nice, we're killing two birds with one stone today. I tore my glove. I've never used gloves. I figured I'd give them a shot. They're kind of nice, but this is why I never really used them. It's because they tear. But these are the disposable ones, so if I had a pair that you can like rewash and use again. I bought the gloves this time because I know transmission fluid stains and I didn't really want to get it on my skin or whatever. So the oil's almost done. I went ahead and cleaned off the oil plug. Checked the seal. The seal still looks pretty good. So we are good in that department once that's done. And then we'll get the filter off, which is right there. All the maintenance on this car is like easy. You don't have to go far to get to the oil plug, far to the oil filter. The transmission plug is actually like right there, so it's all within easy reach, which is very nice. And you don't have to put the car up on jacks, at least for this anyway. But again, you never want to over tighten your plug. It's not necessary. Just a nice little snug. And that's good. And now we will do the oil filter. Hopefully this is over far enough. All right. Filter's off. Okay, and now we'll get our new filter ready, of course. Take your finger, dip it into the new oil, and then rub it around the seal. The threads. So then that way the gasket doesn't actually come off when you take it off the next time around. Here's the old filter, so the gasket's still intact. It's still on there. So that's good. That's a better look of where it goes. So come on. There we go. Nice and snug. As far as it'll tighten, so that should be good. You can see that's actually still dripping. We'll go ahead and plug up the transmission. Okay, now we need to tighten it down. And again, this is something that you don't want to over tighten, so it'll get snug. We're just about there. Okay, so that's pretty snug now. Wipe it off. Okay, good as new. And then we'll just put the cover back, put the screw back in. Probably gonna sit funny for a little bit because we bent it back, but that's okay. Again, if you have like an impact, this would probably come in handy right about now. And this one, I'd really wanna make sure we don't over tighten, because I'm sure that there's not much to that, so it'll probably rust, break off. So that's it. We got the oil plug back in, the oil filter's in place, and the transmission drain plug is good. Don't forget about the mess that I made, but that's okay. So that's in place. We're all good under here, so let's head up top and start filling things up. Looks just as bad as the oil. All right then. Okay, so we're gonna put the engine oil in first. because I'm going to actually have the engine running for when we start filling up the transmission. So, grab the funnel. And this one takes all 5 quarts. It's actually like 5.3, but 5 quarts seems to have done the trick every time so far. This is the third oil change I've done on this car, by the way, since I've had it. This is going to take a while. Alright, so I just checked it. Our oil is perfectly topped off. 5 quarts. And now it's time to do this. And we're going to start by adding 1 quart of the Mercon LV. I hate leaves. Wait till you see what difference in color this fluid looks like compared to what came out of this transmission. Look at that, see? It looks, it's got a cherry color to it. Now that is what good fluid looks like. Mine looked far from that. It's really breezy. I don't want any of this stuff to blow around anywhere. And then I'm going to start it. It should be okay to start now with that much fluid in there. Let's let that drain out, I guess. But we will reset the oil life monitor. So first off, we want to reset this for myself. So the oil has been changed. It was at 53%, so we'll just reset it. Alright, so now we're at 100%. And we'll start it up. Okay, we got pressure, so that's good. Everything with the oil, engine oil is in place. Okay, now at this point, I put 4 quarts in, so I'm going to put the dipstick back in, check to see where it's at, and go from there. I might need 2 hands, I don't want this to drip everywhere, so. Okay, so right now, it's sitting the full mark. I don't know how well that's coming in. It's sitting at the full mark. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take it out for a drive, let that fluid get warm, and then, you know, once it's been driven, then I'm going to check to see where it's sitting at. So we'll see if 4 quarts actually does it, or if I have to add any of the fifth one. So make sure all my stuff's here. All the caps are back on. We're good there. That's pushed back. All right, so we'll take it for a drive and see how it acts. No jerkiness, which is good. We are moving, so that is good.
Ooh, very smooth shift into drive, so that's good. It is actually shifting really smooth right now. I wonder how low that transmission fluid could have been now that I know that it's leaking somewhere. Actually shifting a lot better than I think it probably ever has. It's amazing how something so simple like fluid can actually make a difference in the way that something operates. I mean, as of this second, it's shifting better than I honestly think it ever has since I've actually had the car. And I thought it shifted pretty good in the beginning when I first got the car, so this is an improvement over that. Alright, so we just got back to my house. Still very smooth. Very nice. Alright, that should be enough to warm it up, so I'll check the fluid one more time.
Nothing smells hot, so that's good. Hammer down. Probably be right in these hash marks here. You can kind of see where it says check hot, so it probably should be in this area, and that should be fine. Now when we filled it up it was over, but now that we've driven it, it should be lower, I would think. So we'll see what it looks like.
looks of it, it's still showing up right around those hash marks, so I'm going to say that we're probably in good shape. I'll keep an eye on it over the next couple of days. Once I start driving it more, but as of right now, I think my very first transmission drain and fill, as they call it, was a success. So we got our clean oil, and we got our clean transmission fluid. We're in good shape. The nice thing about this is I won't have to do the transmission again until probably around 110,000, 120,000. So this should last us for a little while. Okay, so it's the following day, and I drove the car this morning to do a few things, and I came back just a little bit ago while everything was hot and I had the engine running and stuff, and I checked the fluid, and I ended up adding a little more of the fifth quart. I dumped in maybe about half of it, and it actually is showing up on the dipstick now a little bit better, because it really wasn't showing up at all when I got back. But it still continued to drive perfectly fine, which is good. Like I said, I'm just going to keep an eye on it over the next few days to see if I have to add the rest of that fifth quart in there. Because 5 quarts, I think, as I mentioned, was the typical amount that goes back into the transmission from what I've read. I'll just keep an eye on it. But other than that, I'm really having some good shifts now. It's shifting very smooth. Now, the one thing that I wanted to look at briefly from yesterday was the leak. And I think I might have an idea of what it is, because I noticed it when I was editing the video yesterday of the actual transmission change, fluid change, I should say. I think it's coming from the side of the transmission, and I don't know how well we're gonna be able to see it without like taking the wheel and the splash guard and stuff off, but I kind of noticed it when I was editing yesterday that some of the boots might have been wet. I don't know, it was raining, you know, the roads are wet, so this is probably all road wetness that we're seeing, possibly. It's hard to tell now, but there's basically a bushing that connects the half shaft axle to the transmission, the actual like drive shaft, and I guess the bushing goes bad on these. Something about one of the parts corrodes and it starts cutting into the bushing, like the rust. I don't think we'll be able to see it from the other side. This might be a little more in-depth work. Not really. Maybe. Yeah, that part that I zoomed in on, that's roughly about what I was trying to aim for. I think that bushing might be the issue. It kind of looks like that could be the issue. Thank you. So yeah, it looks like it's been wet. I'm pretty sure that's probably what it is. Something that I honestly would like to attempt to do, but it's something I don't know if I have the tools to do. So it would be considered the first major repair that the Escape's gonna need since I've had it. The part itself, it comes as a kit, I guess, and the kit isn't really too expensive, but it's a very labor-intense job. You have to take the pretty much the entire shaft out on this side to get to it. You need some special tools that I do not have. I guess we'll just see where it goes. But other than that, I added just a little bit more fluid, like I said. I'll keep my eye on it. It's running really good, shifting really good. I'm pleased with it at the moment. Just got to figure out what the deal is with the leak. So if you guys like this vlog, please like, comment, and subscribe. Hopefully everybody learned something today about the transmission drain and fill on a Escape 2009 and up, I should say. So thank you all for watching. Don't forget to check out Mike's Vehicle Spotlight, which is the official vehicle touring segment that I post on this channel. And other than that, I will see you guys next time.